Hi everyone, so I'm back from my vacay, and maybe you guys can't notice this because I don't know why, but on this light I seem a little bit more unnaturally pale. I'm not really sure, maybe it's the light outside, I don't know. I got my hair done today, so yay, but the problem is that my hair was curled in front and then basically after 10 minutes it flopped. Look at that, it just looks horrible right now. Okay, so today I'm going to be showing you a fall inspired makeup tutorial. Let's get down to it. It's going to be like an orangey a fall makeup tutorial, and hopefully you guys like it. I'm gonna be doing my eyebrows last today because I'm going to be doing another review about these eyebrow products which I just bought. So the first thing I'm going to be using is my NYX Cosmetic Jumbo Eye Pencil in Sparkle Leopard, and I'm going to be applying it as a base on my eyelids. Now I'm going to be taking my Sigma Concealer Brush in F70 and just kind of smudging this out. Now I'm going to be taking a blending brush. You can use the Sigma E25 blending brush if I'm correct. So I'm going to be using my Makeup Geek eyeshadows. I'm going to be using Chickadee, Cream Brulee, and Preppy. And I'm going to be applying this into my crease area. Now the one thing you want to do with this look is make sure that you blend it really well. You can take another clean blending brush, or you can just kind of wipe off the excess of this brush off your hand or on paper and then just blend. Alright, now I'm going to be taking from Makeup Geek the eyeshadow in Cosmopolitan. So I'm going to be taking my Sigma Beauty brush in E55 and then just dab this on your eyelid. You're going to be dabbing it on the middle part of your eyelid. Leave a little bit space right by the tear duct area, and don't go all the way in into the outer V area. Now I'm taking a smaller brush, the Smudge E25 from Sigma, and I'm going to be picking up Shimma Shimma from Makeup Geek, and I'm going to be applying this on my tear duct area and blend it into Cosmopolitan. So this is what it looks like when I applied a Shimma Shimma and Cosmopolitan. Now we're gonna focus on the outer V area. For the outer V area, I'm first going to be using Brown Sugar, and then if it's not dark enough, I'm going to be going on to Moco, and if that's not dark enough, then I'm going to be going on to Bada Bing. I will be explaining this as I do it. I'm also going to be taking my Sigma Blending Brush in E25. And just apply this on the outer V area. As you can see, I'm tapping it right there. And then blend it right into the crease like that. And then take a clean blending brush and then make sure to blend this. Now I'm taking a pencil brush from Sigma, the E30, and then really defining the V area, a mix of Mocha and Brown Sugar. And then just blend this out. I'm going to be taking a clean eye shading brush in E55, and I'm going to be picking up the blending shade which we applied into the crease and above crease area, applying them on my lower eyelid area like that, and then just blend it. I'm going to be picking up the Sigma pencil brush E30, which we use to define the outer V area, and with what's left over, I'm just going to be smudging it like right where we apply this other shade, like right below there. I'm picking up a little bit more Mocha and just going again over this. Now to give this look a little bit of a more shine to it, I'm going to be taking from Makeup Geek the pigment called Birthday Wish. You can see swatches on my website. I will include a link to the swatches. It's a beautiful like orangey shade, and now I'm going to be applying it on my center of my eyelid just to kind of make my eyes pop a little bit more. I'm going to be taking my Sigma blending brush, and I'm just going to apply a little bit on my lower eyelid. All right, now I'm going to be taking a black eyeliner pencil and applying it into my waterline. Now I'm going to be taking my Sigma eyeliner brush in E05, smudge this pencil, so there's no clumping or anything of that sort. When we're done with that, I'm going to be taking Flamed Out, my CoverGirl mascara, and just applying it on my lower lashes. So now I'm going to be applying my favorite false lashes. I'm going to be taking my gel liner from Essence, and I'm going to be taking my Sigma eyeliner in E10, and I'm going to be applying a thick line on my top eyelid. And for lips, I'm going to be taking my MUA Luxe London Lip Lacquer in Tranquility. I'm actually going to be using my Sigma Concealer Brush in F70 to apply this, because if you saw my previous video, I said that it's always better to use it with a fluffier synthetic brush. And yeah. Now I'm going to be taking my blush from Illamasqua. It's the shade Create. It's like a bronzing shade. And I'm going to be taking my tapered face blush in F25 from Sigma. And I'm going to be packing on a light coat of this bronzer. I like to call it bronzer because it really does remind me. And I'm going to be using it as a blush. Tap off the excess, as you can see I was doing. Just a very light coat, so you get a light bronzed effect. A little bit on your forehead up here. To highlight my skin, I'm taking my MUA Undress Your Skin, the Shimmer Highlighter. It's the one with the pink undertone. I know that there's one with like a golden undertone. I have not seen it online yet, and please tell me if you like it. I actually wanna buy it. And with this fan brush, which is very thin and fluffy, I'm just gonna apply this on like my cheek area. Down my nose, a little bit right up my lip. And that's it, like right there even. All right, so this is the look, and the last thing I have to do is I'm going to be filling in my eyebrows. And the reason I'm not doing that right now in front of you guys is because I'm going to be doing an individual eyebrow tutorial, which you can actually see by clicking right here. You're going to be seeing me how I use these new NYX eyebrow gels, and you're going to also get a really quick review. So if you want to see the completed look up with the eyebrows, so actually if you want to see the eyebrow tutorial, then click on the link right here and you're going to see how I use these. And if not, stay tuned, you're going to see a still picture of how it looks with the filled out eyebrows.